If you want to reinvigorate general aviation, it takes much more than just delivering a great aircraft. You've got to be able to deliver a great aircraft at a price that the market can afford to pay. And that really requires a complete root and branch rethink of how you manufacture the entire aircraft. Traditionally, if you wanted an engine, you'd go to an engine supplier. If you wanted avionics, you'd go to an avionics supplier. If you wanted bearings or gears or composites, you'd go to specialists in each of those fields. But the problem that we find ourselves in presently is, as general aviation demand has dwindled over the last few decades, a lot of the suppliers that used to routinely supply into those industries now find most of their business with commercial air transport, with business jets, and with bigger, higher value aircraft.
This is the first bit they've got, which is very rough. It's really rough at the moment. But I'm excited to see the rest of it, see how it all looks.
What we're doing here at Hill that's different is we're essentially bringing back the old-fashioned, vertically integrated approach to manufacturing, but with a modern twist that all of the latest technology in terms of computer numerically controlled machinery and modern computer-enhanced manufacturing means that we can do this much more cost-effectively than ever before. The other challenge that you've got in general aviation, of course, is that the volumes aren't really that large. And so it's vital that the processes that you adopt while you're developing your aircraft are appropriate for realistic sales volumes that you're going to be able to achieve. And so one of the areas that we've spent an awful lot of time developing and honing our approach on is how we make gears. Now, the simple spur gears and helical spur gears are straightforward enough because that the gear grinding and gear shaping equipment that you need to produce those is relatively inexpensive. But helicopters are quite unique in that they require at least two sets of spiral bevel gears, which are much more expensive to manufacture. And so one of the processes that we've been developing here is how we make these gears without either having to go out to the existing supply chain or having to invest in equipment that really is too big for our market volumes.
So this one's just finished being milled, and that is the complete finished product compared to the start. Wow, it's a lot heavier as well.
Yeah, that is. You can tell how much lighter it is now.
So you'd start with this type of blank, and then after that entire process, there's still more processes to go through, like heat treating, and then it comes back to you, right?
Yeah, for the finishing.
And so one of the things that we've been developing for our gearbox is a method of being able to directly cut and then hard machine high quality aerospace grade gears using much more flexible machinery like 5-axis CNC machines. Now, this has traditionally been considered possible, but not always practical, because these machines are a bit slower than the conventional gear grinding machines. But of course, that's not a problem for us, because with our volumes, a single machine would be able to produce around 500 aircraft sets of spiral bevel gears for us per year. So that's more than good enough from an economic point of view. And of course, that gives us the kinds of control of quality, the control of scheduling, and importantly, the control of cost. And that allows us to buy the very best aerospace grade materials, invest in the very best equipment, and deliver the very best products. So one of the areas that we've been working on is essentially taking a billet of high grade material and then cutting these teeth directly using a 5-axis CNC machine. And what you'll see in this video here that we've produced today is essentially the process that we've been through to deliver that, and then how we've eventually ended up in the situation where we can produce spiral bevel gears directly on a 5-axis CNC machine all the way up to the aerospace grade tolerances that we need. So this is one of the examples of the areas where we're combining the idea of simple, vertically integrated manufacturing with modern technology and a very clear focus on who and what our market is and how we hit that price point.